Jai Shri Mataji, everyone. A very good morning to all. Let's bow down to Shri Mataji's holy lotus feet, raise our kundalini and put on a bandhan. Now let's say the three great mantras.
Shri Nirmala.
Now let's take Shri Ganesha mantra 4 times. Om Tvamev Sakshat Shri Ganesh Sakshat Shri Adi Shakti Mataji Shri Nirmala Devi Namo Namaha. Om Tvamev Sakshat Shri Ganesh Sakshat Shri Adi Shakti Mataji Shri Nirmala Devi Namo Namaha. Om Tvamev Sakshat Shri Ganesh Sakshat Shri Adi Shakti Mataji Shri Nirmala Devi Namo Namaha. Om Tvamev Sakshat Shri Ganesh Sakshat Shri Adi Shakti Mataji Shri Nirmala Devi Namo Namaha. Jai Shri Mataji, Jai Shri Ganesh. Let's settle down our attention and ourselves and keep our attention on Mother Earth, on our Muladhara Chakra. Let's keep our right hand on Mother Earth and pray to Shri Mataji, Mother, please clear our left channel. Please clear our left side. Mother, please remove all obstacles from my left channel and dissolve them into Mother Earth. Mother, please remove all emotional imbalances from my left side and dissolve them into Mother Earth. One mantra to Sri Mahakali Bhairavnath. Om Tvamev Sakshat Sri Mahakali Bhairavnath Sakshat Sri Adi Shakti Mataji Shri Nirmala Devi Namo Namaha. Shri Mataji, please come into our left channel as Shri Ganesha and fill our being with pure joy, pure love and pure vibrations. one mantra to Sri Ganesha. Om Tvameva Sakshat Shri Ganesh Sakshat Shri Adi Shakti Mataji Shri Nirmala Devi Namo Namaha. Now slowly move your right hand back into your lap when you are ready. We'll quickly clear our right side as well. Pray to Shri Mataji. Mother, please remove all over planning and futuristic thinking within me and dissolve it into ether. Mother, please purify my liver and remove all the negativities from my liver. Mother, please remove all ego within me, all the anger within me, all anxiety within me, and all the frustration within me, and dissolve them into ether. One mantra to Sri Mahasaraswati Hanumana. Om Tvameva Sakshat Sri Mahasaraswati Hanumana Sakshat Sri Adi Shakti Mataji Shri Nirmala Devi Namo Namaha. Shri Mataji, please come into our right side as Shri Hanumana. And please remove all obstacles in our Karma Shakti. Mother, please enlighten our right channel and let us enjoy the sweet side or the sweet aspect of the right side. Jai Shri Mataji. Slowly bring your left hand back into your lap. Now raise both of your hands up to the heart level. And pray to Mother. Mother, please clear our central channel. Please clear our Sushumna Nadi. Remove all the obstacles from our spiritual evolution. And help us grow deeper and stronger in our spiritual ascent. Please strengthen our faith in you, Mother, and also strengthen our faith for ourselves and help us completely surrender each and everything in your holy lotus feet. Please give us the strength of heart so we are not afraid and we don't have any self-doubt, but just the pure love and power of your vibrations. Mother, please strengthen our hearts and make us fearless, no matter what's happening around us. Mataji, I completely surrender to your holy lotus feet. Please accept me in your holy lotus feet, O Divine Mother. Please shower your love and blessings upon us and accept us all in your holy lotus feet. साक्षात् श्री आदि शक्ति माताजी श्री निर्मला देवी नमो नमः। श्री माताजी, लेट्स जस्ट मेडिटेट इन साइलेंस फॉर अ फ्यू मिनट्स। And slowly open your eyes when you are ready. We'll now listen to a talk by Shimataji. This is a continuation of where we left last time. The talk on improvement of Muladhara.
Very confused. Because there is no wisdom in this kind of life. To become just a sex-oriented personality. It is actually just other way now. If you are money-oriented, you want to preserve money. If you are position-oriented, you want to preserve it. If you get one little antique piece, you want to preserve it. And why not this property of yours, which is the highest of all, to be preserved, to be adorned, to be worshipped? I'm quite worried on that point, that secretly people are indulging into such things. And they're hypocritical sometimes. They don't mind being hypocritical about it. They are Sahaja Yogis, all right. But in this matter, they think they can go about the way they like. And sometimes some of them say that, Mother, I said it's all right. I never said so. There's one point I cannot compromise is this. You must have a chaste outlook towards yourself, towards your life, towards your being, towards your personality. You are saints. And if a saint doesn't have a good character, I call it the character, the essence of character, he's not a saint. So this purity has to be maintained. There cannot be any compromise on that. You cannot hit at the roots of everything. If it works out in a collective way, nobody cheats oneself. Nobody deceives oneself. And puts the mind into right track of ascent, thinking about the ascent, how you are going to rise, thinking of the moments when you had the joy, thinking of the day when you met me first, thinking of all the other beautiful and holy things. Your mind can be cleansed. And whenever such a thought comes in, you have to say, not this, not this, not this. It's more mental than physical, I think. I know it's difficult, but if you can get realization, why not this also? You all have to understand that there is no compromise on this. And the day will come, if you continue with it, you'll be thrown away completely. Just like any other devil is thrown out. So there is no compromise. Tell yourself. Don't deceive yourself. Don't cheat yourself. You cannot ascend. If there is any lurking thing within you, you will be dragged down because that's your weakness. You will become weaker and weaker and weaker. Only question is, where is your attention? Divert your attention. First you will need some exercise, some effort, and afterwards it will come automatically. You won't have to exert, you won't have to worry. On the contrary, it will become impossible how to be otherwise. So much conditioning is there. We have played into the hands of conditioning. We have ruined ourselves. This conditioning is the subtlest of all and the worst of all. It's impossible to combat in Sahaja Yoga. Unless and until you individually take up the responsibility of looking after it. Muladhara is one of the most delicate and the most powerful chakra. It has so many folds and it has so many dimensions. If your Muladhara is not alright, your memory will fail. If your Muladhara is not alright, to begin with, your wisdom will fail. You will have no sense of direction. The insanity that is now crawling up in America before they become 40 years of age is because their Muladhara is wrong. Most of the diseases which are incurable come because of weak Muladharas. On the physical side, on the mental side, most of the mental problems, disorder, most, I would say 90%, are due to weak Muladhara. If a person has a strong Muladhara, powerful Muladhara, it doesn't get into trouble. Because you know there's a very strong hold of that Muladhara on the back here. And when your mind goes off, you blame the brain. It's not the brain. Mostly, it is the Muladhara. So for physical safety and for your emotional safety also, you have to have a sane type of attitude towards Muladhara. That's why I'm very anxious that you all should get married. And after marriage, after a few days, you find that your attention start diverting to other problems of married life. But not if you are not a surgeon. Because the sensationalization has become the main theme of the modern life. When you are tossed about on the rough sea of all these deliberate actions of the people, media, books, ideas, everything creates this horrible, excitable temperament. Such a person doesn't have any patience, doesn't have any balance. Actually, he's hypocritical and has a very bad left fissure. So many complications take place with it. Before realization, forget the past. Whatever you have done, forget it. Just don't worry. But remember one thing, that you have damaged your Muladhara, so you have to look after it. You have to soothe it down. You have to bring it to normalcy. You have to make it a healthy, balanced center so that Sri Ganesha can rule over. Talking about Sri Ganesh, you know, vibrations become too much for me. We talk of innocence, but to awaken innocence within ourselves, we must be on the full watch, on the full alertness about our minds. What is it thinking? Where is it? Where is this thief going? Is he trying to do some tricks? Is he up to some tricks? All right. You have to be alert, very alert. I've been thinking of talking about it since long. But now I have to tell you one thing, that you'll be exposed. That is another quality of Mahamaya. She'll expose you. You'll be exposed if you try to play tricks with me. With me means with your Kundalini. If you try to play tricks with your Kundalini, you'll be exposed. and you'll be ashamed of yourself. So please be careful, very careful about it, that you again make your Muladhara very healthy and powerful. May God bless.
While we are in meditation, let's just give a few bandhans and pray for our brothers and sisters. So let's put a bandhan to Logan and Pam Moodley. To Uncle Peter Hewitson, to Brett Johnson. Jai Shri Mataji. Thank you. Thank you, Mother. Let's take the three great mantras.
Shri Nirmala Devi.
श्री निर्मला देव्यै नमो नमः। बोलो श्री आदिशक्ति माता जी श्री निर्मला देवी जी की जय। जय श्री माता जी। Let's bow down, raise our kundalini and put on a bandhan. Thank you for joining everyone. Thank you, Shimataji, for a beautiful morning meditation. Thank you, Mother, for coming in our hearts and blessing us with your love and vibrations. Shimataji. May you all have a lovely day ahead. I'll keep the some music running for 5 more minutes. Jai Shri Mataji. जय शिवा।